Hey everybody, it's the Poltergeist. Welcome back to more Final Fantasy V. In the last episode, we entered the fire-powered ship, which is probably my least favorite dungeon in the game. But we gotta do it, because if we can't do the rest of the game, which is cooler than this stupid stinking place. I hate this place. It's so boring. There's like nothing interesting here at all. What? Don't confuse Ferris. The thing about confusion, is that if somebody is hit by a physical attack while they're confused, it actually cures the confusion. And what's nice about that is that the healing staff, even though it only casts cure when you attack with it, it still counts as a physical attack. So you can still cure confusion with it. So you can heal somebody and cure their confusion in one fell swoop, which is really nice. Unfortunately, it only works on one person at a time. Oh, good! This entire fucking area was a dead end for an elixir. Where the hell do I go? Up here? Probably up here. Yeah, there's a lift here that goes chugunk, 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 chugunk. One perfect tile square at a time. Anyway. Da-da-da-da. Yeah, I should have recorded this last night. Even if I had to record it at like 1 in the morning, it would have been a better situation than right now. Not that I'm in some like shitty situation. Could I have said that any stupider? But I know as soon as I finish this, I have to go like wash a whole bunch of dishes. It's like, ugh, what a pain in the ass. Wash the kitchen. I don't actually have anything to do this week because nobody cares about your stupid D&D campaign. We've been doing a D&D campaign. I'm gonna say it anyway because I have literally nothing to talk about going through this fucking dungeon. Son of a bitch, you idiot! Don't heal him. What? Oh, for crying out loud, Ferris! And I've had the next session ready for 2 weeks now, but stuff keeps coming up. Oh, I can't play because I got a thing that I scheduled at the same time as we always play. It's like, oh, good. Thanks for that. That was well thought out. Well thought out thing you did there. Anyway. I'm just gonna be glad to finally get out of this stupid place because this is my least favorite part of the game. It's just so boring. It's like this one dungeon is like literally 3/4 of Final Fantasy VI. It's just going through factories and mechanical areas and blah blah blah. There's conveyor belts here. I forget. I think you need to get in the one at the bottom, but there's something else you can actually pick up here that's pretty nice. But I forget what it is. That's a lift that goes up to the middle. I don't know where this goes. A secret passage. And a random attack. By the same fucking enemies we've encountered a million times already. How interesting. You know, I recently realized while I was planning stuff for a thing. Ooh, a green beret. That I can't think of a single reason why, like, random encounters would ever need to exist, you know? I mean, it works sometimes. What the fuck am I doing? Green beret. Green, you can't equip that? Okay, good, there you go. Yeah. Like, I mean, Undertale did perfectly fine without random battles, you know? I'm not saying every game in the world should be like Undertale, but, and you know, D&D campaigns usually don't have, or tabletop, pen and paper RPGs. I hate saying D&D because there's like 100 million games, even though I've only ever played D&D. What? Oh man, there's a thing. Oh, they're doing a thing. Okay, get out of here, I don't care! Jeez, I'm gonna have enough bullshit random battles to worry about in the sequence that comes immediately after this. What the is this the boss? I don't want to fight the boss. I don't want to fight the boss because there's treasure in here I haven't picked up. I hate everything. I think if you come up here, this brings you to a lift. You quit yawning, man. This brings you to a lift. Yeah, this brings you back up to the door on the right of this area up here. And if you go on the one on the left, I think that brings you to that chest. Yeah. Fall so slowly. What? What's the point of doing this? It's like you're lifting something. But there's nothing there. Anyway. This is turning out to be like one of the worst episodes I've ever made. Like, seriously. Talking about random crap that has nothing to do with the game, I'm getting annoyed that I even have to play this game because I don't like this dungeon. This dungeon. Get me the fuck out of here. Let's try door number 3! Whoa, it's so interesting! Did I do it good? That does not make any sense spatially. You know? Fuck off. Thieves gloves, though. You know, I mean, it's not even really a big deal. Oh my gosh, I'm all the way back at the beginning. Fuck. Because you can actually come back to this dungeon pretty much at any... This is one of the few dungeons in the game that doesn't go anywhere at any point throughout the entire game. You can come back to this at just about any time, as long as you have access to this ship. Which is unfortunate that, like, the one dungeon to stick around for the whole game is the most boring one. I don't know why I don't like these robot... Well, actually, I know exactly why I don't like these robot dungeons. These factory mechanical dungeons very much. It's because of Final Fantasy VI, which I'm not a huge fan of. Buried treasure. Moonring blade. Hot diggity dog. That's a weapon that, can be equipped by... I think it can be equipped by thieves, ninjas, stuff like that. Oh, we don't have ninjas yet. Spoilers! And it does just as much damage from the back row as it does from the front row. So you can put somebody in the back. Can anybody... Do I have anybody who can actually equip that, though? Because I'd like to know that in advance. Like, yeah, thieves can equip it, but I don't want to send anybody as a thief. Because then I'm going to be running around at 2 miles a second. Say, firepower chip elevator. I think if we go through here, it's for boss time, so let's just go. Nope, we got another room. Never mind. Ignore me. Boy, howdy. No, I want you to... you gotta move this back down. No! That's not right at all. You gotta keep this up here, because when you push this... When you push this switch... moves that over there. It's a good thing that actually extends instead of just moving, because it totally could have just moved. That destroys that. That opens that up, which means I can get over here now. That moves that, which means you can get back over there, but it's a one-way trip. Oh my gosh. Nobody cares. What even are those things, and why are they in this ship? It's so stupid. It's just stupid. Oh, because I had that one switch in the wrong spot that I totally could have realized was the case. Like, suck my fucking dick, Final Fantasy V. Okay, so do pull this. Go back over here. No! I'm not fighting you guys. Not doing it. No. Dude! Fuck, this is just one? It's just one. Well, you know what that means, is that there would have been those, like, motor trap guys. Pull this, the witch's switch.
And pull this switch.
And I'm yawning, too! Oh, boy. What's in here? I don't... Poltergeist, I hate you so much. Get out of my way. Elixir. Whoop-de-doo. Here come those idiots now. Here's the boss! I remember this boss being kind of weird. Queen Karnak? What's going on? Oh no. Infidels! You shall pay for interfering with my revival! Oh no, everything's on fire. Everything is on fire, everything- Oh my gosh, no, no, no! Ah! Living... Oh, no, it's Liquid Flame. It's not Living Flame, it's Liquid Flame. Okay, so obviously this is probably going to move to Blizzara. I don't actually know. Because who the fuck can ever know in these games? In these games where, like, the type science isn't concrete ever, you can never know if a fire enemy is going to be weak to or absorb ice, you know? Because, like, oh, it's so hot they can't be hurt by ice, or they're a cold monster so they don't like ice. Like, either one makes sense, so... How could you possibly know which one it's going to be before you try something? Anyway. I'm going to try and cast slow on this. I think this thing has, like, some weird gimmick. Oh my gosh, that was a lot of damage. Yeah, you use your blaze. Oh, now it's a hand. Oh no. Try attacking with my spell blade. You fucking Clodmeister. You aquamaroon. I can't believe you missed. You're a jailier. You know, I don't think I've ever mentioned it before, but I actually like this version. Obviously this game was originally released on Super Nintendo. You can kind of tell based on just looking at it that it was originally made. Oh my gosh! That it was originally released on Super Nintendo. In the original version of the song, in that part near the end of the loop where it goes da 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 da. In the original version of the song, it had more trumpets, like it had a melody, too. And I actually like this version better, because it feels more final to have, like, just this deep, thundering music. You fucking idiot. Man, you're a moron. You're like Duster. Oh, boy. Yeah, I'll see if I can't sing the part when it comes up. And then it goes da 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 da. Like, there's this really loud, like, shrill. That was the most annoying thing ever. But there's this really loud and shrill trumpet part in the original version of the song. But in this, it doesn't have that. What? What the fuck, man? Man, you can't hit this. We can't hit this guy for sh- Oh, and there he goes. Why the fuck are you so damn strong? Also, I have Cura. Why the fuck am I not using it? No, I don't. Why the hell don't I have Cura? What? Did I not buy that in Karnak? That was in Karnak, wasn't it? Yeah, you use Magnet. I don't give two shits. Whatever. Use a Phoenix down on him, because whatever. The thing is, this thing only ever attacks one person at a time, so who cares? Once upon a time, who fucking cares? Blizzara, bitch. Suck it. I mean, suck it. Oh, that's gonna kill both of them, isn't it? Nope. Just killed Gallif. Because of course it fucking did. And Bart's can't hit for shit, so I'm just gonna have him use a Phoenix down. Da-da-da-da-da-da! Okay, now you gotta get that cure off, which isn't gonna do jack shit because it's level 1. Yeah, 40. Oh, man, there's so much healing. Let's try and steal from this guy. I mean, you never know. Nothing to steal. Well, that's boring. And this thing doesn't have shit for... Like this, I don't know what the deal is with this hand form. Like, ice doesn't hurt it at all. And it's got, like, 400 evasion. Like, what's the deal with the thing? Oh, right, you know what? You've got the healing staff. You should be using that. Because it's, like, way objectively better. Don't hit him. You fucking moron! Yeah, you go ahead, keep using Ray. See if I give a shit. That actually cured the paralysis that Ray initially inflicted on him, so congratulations. You accomplished literally nothing. You know what? I think, actually, the healing rod has perfect accuracy. So I can totally hit him with that. Except, of course, that didn't trigger him to go out of his hand form. Why would you hit him twice in a row? And now he's dead. No, now she's dead. Oh, good. Oh, good, you killed my healer. Oh, that's so nice of you. Anyway. Next person to get a turn is going to be you, so I'm going to use the frost rod. Because this should cast... What? Oh. That should cast Ice 3, which should do, like, buku damage. Yeah. There you go. That's how it's done. Flame Bow, Running Strike. Flame Bow. Anybody else ever watch Mega Man? Anybody else familiar with Mega Man 8? I always thought it was so hilarious how dead Flame or Sword Man sounds when he says Flame Sword. He's like, Running Strike.
Flame Sword.
Queen Karnak. I was being controlled by something. An evil spirit desires to envelop everything in darkness. Your Highness, the crystals such as a machine for destroying them. Something evil is in your power to resurrect itself. Please have the right crystal. It's just that pipe. I ain't going over there yet. Fuck that. No, don't make me go over there yet. Don't worry about me. More importantly, protect the crystal. But you're gonna die, man. You're gonna die. Oh, man. Do I ever really... I wanna... Dude, I want to get through here. Oh, yeah, there we go. I want to go back to the save point, man. Because I don't want to do this next part in this video. I'm going to, like, pop a gasket, probably. What? I didn't move. I mean, sure, I moved, but I didn't walk. Jeez. Like, what, if I was on a conveyor belt, I'd just be getting random encounters? Jeez. Anyway. I know this is a huge fucking waste of time, but I don't give a shit. I don't feel like playing this anymore, so I'm gonna use the cottage and I'm gonna save, and I will meet you back in the room where we find the liquid flame, and we'll get on to the next part of this game. So yeah, see you then. Bye.